Today is Tuesday, April 7th, and I just wanted to give a quick update on the peppers. They're doing so much better since I added a heat mat as well as a grow light. As you can see, I have germination, whereas as of the 2nd of April, I did not. So, we're still not at 100% germination on these peppers, and I don't know if we will get there or not, but we've made progress, and I'm happy with that. It's gonna be really, really nice today, like 80 degrees almost for the first time of the year. So I'm gonna go ahead and put these guys outside, let them get some natural sunlight with all the other plants, which I'll give you a quick look at. The cucumbers are just going crazy. And that basil that my neighbor gifted me is gonna need to be put in a pot here soon. But everything's looking good. I'm starting to get some germination on some of my herbs. Let's see, what's that? Cilantro. So that's awesome. Still no rosemary or lavender yet. And I think I see a parsley. Yeah, there's a little parsley. This is the basil that I started. And the oregano. And then this is the dill that I started. Back here, you can see all of my tomatoes. I did have 100% germination on my tomatoes. So they're doing great. And I'm just about to put all of these outside to get some sunlight, but I wanted to give a quick update before I did that. These are my zinnias. They're going crazy as well. So anyways, I just wanted to update you guys and also thank all of my friends and the Friends of Roots and Refuge Farm for giving me the tips that helped me to get my peppers to germinate. And what I've done is I've actually journaled so far what I've done with my seeds because I want to not only keep learning for myself and remember from year to year what I have done and what's been successful and what hasn't. But I kind of want to pass that down to my kids as well. And maybe one day they'll want a garden and they can learn from it too. Anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and get these guys outside. And until next time, y'all stay chill. Thanks for watching. So it is still April 7th, and I knew that this morning I wanted to put my plants outside for just a little bit to get some natural light. I also knew that if I left them out there too long, it could kill them because it would get too hot and they just weren't ready for that. And the only reason I felt comfortable leaving them out for a little bit is because they've been sitting in the sun with the windows open in my kitchen here since I started them anyway. So they were already kind of acclimated to being outside. And I've also been taking them out for an hour or so a day, anyways, and they've been fine. But today, my son was much too fussy for me to go back out and get these when I had originally intended to. So the tomatoes did take a pretty big hit, but that's okay because I started way more than I really needed. And I should still have a few of each variety, so it'll be okay. I lost a couple peppers too, I think. They might be able to spring back, but I kind of doubt it. And then my herbs probably won't bounce back from this, but that's okay. I've got time, I can start some more herbs, and I've got plenty of what I started that I think will be able to pull through. I just won't take them out anymore, and I just won't risk it. With my son being fussy, it's just not worth the risk of not being able to get out there when I need to get them brought back in. So for those of you who are starting seeds, I wanted to put this video out there, because some of you might think, oh, okay, well, that's just what you do. You take them outside. No, I was just doing that because that's what I have been doing since I started them. And I was only planning on leaving them out there for like an hour tops. And I forgot about them because my son was being fussy. So don't do what I do. I'm not here to teach anybody how to garden or start seeds. I'm just trying things and showing what I'm doing. But yeah, some of them will bounce back. Some of them won't. And that's okay. But I wanted to show this because gardening is not always about success. Sometimes it's about making mistakes and learning from them.